Just a quick video. I need to do a proper video on this at some point, but I wanted to have a look inside and see what we could possibly do with the innards of this mini PC. But it has been a bit of a pain to open, and I'm sure many other people are going to Google it and out of frustration trying to open this. But there are no screws or anything, it's just plastic clips all the way around. As you can see, I've already partly opened it mainly for this video. You need to pretty much jam a small plastic object into a tiny gap. I would recommend starting at the back. Originally I tried with an old Ulster card, but no matter how hard I tried, it isn't big enough. So even with trying to separate it maybe with your fingernails, it wasn't quite thick enough. I then attempted using one of these, which once again wasn't quite thin enough to get in. So in the end I had to almost give up and use a small knife to just pry this corner open. Once the corner was open, you can then pretty much use either this or this. And it is as simple as just running all the way around, because it is just basic plastic clips. Whoops, not the camera. And it will open up no problem. He says he's struggling to do it. There we go. And it will just pop up. So the plastic clips do seem pretty sturdy, so they don't seem to break while you're doing this, which is great. But it doesn't change the fact that being a Raspberry Pi, I'm quite surprised how awkward it is to get in here, because I'm sure many of you are going to want to make amends to what this can do. I certainly do. Like, one thing, like maybe add a battery, which I think would be a great addition to this. Yeah, still not quite there. There we go, come on. And maybe a few other things. I mean, it is a lovely machine. I've been using it as a little RetroPie machine, just as a for playing around with at the moment, and it has worked out quite well. Now, in here, to get it apart, there is a little clip down here. Just got to lift up, and the keyboard will pop out, he says. For some reason there's some sticky tape here which was never stuck down. Yeah, one keyboard. Now, straight away inside you will notice there's a pretty hefty metal plate slash heatsink. So, cooling wise I found it okay. I haven't run like extensive benchmarks on this yet to see when it starts to fail, but I haven't even looked in here yet, so we'll pick a shower while we're here. Let's pop these. There's just four screws, nice and easy. So at least it's easy from this point of view. So off they come. Four standard looking screws, no horrible tightness, so you can get it off. And hopefully it should just lift off. It seems to be stuck down. Maybe there is like a thermal pad underneath. And half my desk starts to dismantle itself. You've got to give it a bit of a wiggle. But it does come off, he says, then proceeding to not wiggle enough. Come on, giant metal plate. I want to see what's under here. Without breaking it. So give it a bit of a wiggle. And there we have the board. There is a thermal pad underneath, which is what's, it's actually quite sticky, it's what was keeping the whole thing down. There we have the whole board. So we have your general pins here, you know, nice accessible from the back if you need them. With everything else, apart from this thing over here, what that's doing. So what is it? Probably something to do with the Ethernet protocol things. Maybe it's got a better Ethernet on it. I'll have to check that. Is that got full? Oh, whatever. We'll look at that later. But it's pretty much the standard Raspberry Pi in here, stretched across an entire board, which is why my complaint about HDMI ports. It's a shame we didn't have full size ones, but yeah, you get what you get. Hopefully version 2 will be a bit better. But yeah, we can see there's not a lot of space in here. It's a shame this wasn't a little thicker, because you could probably put a battery here. You might still be able to squeeze a battery in here. There's not a lot of room, but might be able to do something, maybe cut a hole and insert a battery there. And that way this could be battery powered, and I think that would be amazing. A portable battery powered little keyboard. Just all you gotta do is plug it into a monitor and away you go. But there we go. That's how you get this little machine apart if you want to do any modding or modifications. There it is, nice to see that this is essentially the heatsink. So it's only a thermal pad on the CPU, which is probably enough, so nothing for the memory. But let's pop this back on and get this back together very quickly. And that nice and firm. Make sure the thermal pad's stuck on. Yeah, stuck back on there. And let's screw this back together very quick. And then pop the keyboard back on. Just watch out for this lip here. It's for the capstock and power LEDs. So just slide that back down here. Should just slot straight back in. Just be nice and gentle, you don't want to damage these. And it should slot in. I think that's in there. And then just snap it back down like so. There we go. And then just slide this back on. Watching aforementioned. Dip it up there. And pop it back on. And it's as simple as just clicking it all back together. And easy. Would have been nice if they had a little tab or something to get this open, but I don't know if it's picking it up, but I have damaged the case slightly here. Should make it easier to open next time, but there we go. A quick dismantle and look inside of the Raspberry Pi 400. If you like this video, please like, comment and subscribe below. Still trying to get this channel to 1,000 subs. It's hard going, but getting there slowly. Please look at some other videos if you're interested in this kind of thing. And I hope you all had fun watching this, and see you next time. Goodbye.